You know, I've been doing this since 2010, desert racing down here, and it's you always get in those moments where you're worn out, you're tired of doing the same thing over and over, but it's special because I get to do it with my dad. I don't think if it was just me, I don't think I'd be doing this still, just because he brings so much joy to my life. I love spending time with him. He's a busy man. He's worked his whole life to get to where he is. So to be able to spend all this time with him, experience where his mind goes when things go wrong, it is a life learning lesson. It teaches me every single day, just learning from him, the challenges that we have down here, how he takes in those, understands them, and works through the process with very clear mind, even in the worst case scenario.
We did talk about it, like, yo, this hood fucking sucks. Let's just wreck it so we get a new one.
Let's put Todd in.
I don't like the angle of it, so let's crash. Put Todd in
it. From 6 a.m. to 6:30, we're done rolling out, trying to get to the track. So we'll get out there to the race course, to whatever section we want to go to, starting at around 7, and we run it until the sun setting, coming back in. So we definitely try and maximize our time on race course. We don't do long lunch stops at restaurants. Our chase guys, you know, cover us on the road, and they also have a cooler with, you know, lunch stuff, sandwich meats, chips, things like that, because we're trying to minimize downtime to run it so we can kind of get that race pace feel. So we'll run it, you know, we'll try and time our sections. If we want to run something twice, we break it down so we know we can optimize every hour of a pre-run day.
Todd, no one said I had talent. This huge ball.
Two-time Nora winner, you'd think.
Back-to-back. Straight. Back-to-back. Let's practice. Two-time back-to-back Nora champ.
It's a little humid today. You can tell by the sweat on my brow. Feels like Florida.
But I've been pushing to close it.
So now you've completely ruined it.
Why?
Because it was at least like to hear.
I tried to push it.
No, because every time I try to push it, you go backwards even further.
See? It's not doing nothing, so that's why I said try.
Broke it, Renee. This is why we can't have nice things. The fucking cow? Satellite's not working either.
So that's my call.
You've
also
broken this. I have no internet.
So am I in?
Just saying, you're truck chief.
What the fuck?
See what happens now.
Okay.
We got nothing. Now we got nothing. Oh, she's angry now. I think that's a good spot for her right there. Hey.
Hi there, Justin. How are you?
How's your day been?
Fantastic. You know, I went half day pre-running with Steve and I lived. It's a good day.
You see anybody running?
No, not yet. So, more front is Pildosola.
Oh, okay.
In Llano, Colorado is Macmillan.
Yep.
Luke and that.
Yep.
Three GPS units. No big deal. I'm sure every team's like that, right?
That was like, well,
Lord of Mercy.
Jeff and I can tell it's
shorter.
It feels shorter. Yeah.
Day two. Keep running, getting our notes. Bryce is on fire like always. It's an honor to be in this seat, even when he's mean to me. I really enjoy it. Doesn't matter. It's never made me cry yet. That's good.
Keep Jared under control, okay?
We'll try.
Don't let him blow any more clothes over.
All right, I may have exaggerated that a little bit. He didn't blow the clothes over, but it was close.
Who's to know if your soul will fade at all? The one you sold to fool the world. You lost your self-esteem along the way.
Tacos.
Back Tom Brady champ right here. it needs to be him.
Yeah, have fun, dude.
Yeah, sure.
Hold
we'll
on.
See. We'll see how it goes.
Hold on tight. If I don't see you again, it's all love. Be safe.
Man,
stay blessed.
Papa got to me. He don't fuck around.
Stay good, dude.
Wherever we go, we're coming back.
Damn.
I'm awesome.
Now Toddy,
Bryce.
Everything good?
What's up?
How are you?
Toad, everything good?
Awesome.
You too. What's up, Warren? All right.
Andy's
going to want to
drive
your pre-runner now, right? No, just because.
You guys already came over from my house?
Yes.
Thanks.
It's we just put on. Yeah, we're in fit perfect. And then we bought the fenders too, but his truck's like 6 inches longer wheelbase. So then we're going to mold my dad's fenders. I had to change just a little bit.
How's this thing run?
I don't know, man.
With the LS3?
I'm like, I got to get like a 6100 truck or something. This just, it's not the pace that the four wheel drives are running. You just can't do it anymore.
Yeah.
And it just lulls you into like marking shit that you don't need to fucking mark.
Yeah.
You know?
Like little ditches.
Yeah, and you're like, oh, this is doing it. And you're like, and in their truck, you're like, boom, you don't even know it. And I'm like, damn it.
I noticed that.
Dude, we almost, have you gone through European?
No.
Okay, so there's like, there's some new like lines that we've made at the 400.
Yeah.
But I forgot I only pre-ran in my race truck at the 400 because this was totaled.
Yeah.
So then I jump in this and we're going. And we're like, Warren's like, hey, our line. So we like fucking bomb up now. It's like burnt in. And we like bomb over and you have to go down like this steep, gnarly grade. And then it's like back uphill. And like we're going down. I'm like, fuck, dude. I don't think we're going to make it up this. And I'm like,
oh, you're talking about the one in the big switchbacks.
Yeah,
where you go around.
Now it's
off
like
the
you
blind
cut way like left and like stay way high and then it drops down and goes up.
Yeah. Whereas before you make a right and come down around to the bottom and then go back up.
Yeah. Well, now there's one, maybe it might be that one that's even like further, and we like bomb down, and I'm like, oh no, and I start like going up, and it starts like losing, it's all silt. So I had to literally like start side hilling it, and then bouncing off rocks to get it to like barely carry over the top. If it wouldn't have went over the top, we were fucked.
Not the kind of valley.
And we were like, oh my god, never again, we forgot we were in the race truck.
And these license plates about to fall off.
Oh my god.
Fixed it. I used to prep race cars. I don't know if you know this, but that makes me officially official to be able to fix Andy McMillan's license plate.
Good. That doesn't matter because if we do this plan, like the pits are going to be stationary. They can't leave. Like, right. We'll only have certain people. Right. Being, like, those people just stay there. It's more like that. He's right there with the hat on.
Oh. With a sideways hat. Hey, straighten your hat out, gangster.
Dude,
he gets out of the truck every day and he's
like,
straighten
your hat out, gangster.
I'm like, how do you not see that standing there right now?
Gangster.
It was like me in middle school, dude.
Because at that age, they just no fucks were given. They just like, no. That's like my dad. They just say shit and I'm like, bro.
Sure.
Yeah.
Where are we going, son? I got to babysit you out today, boy.
Hey, you guys, just stay over there! It's pretty bad.
Mosquitoes affect people differently. In Florida, we just accept the physical raping of our ankles and soft spots, but West Coasters, not ready for this shit.
In Florida, they're so big, they like pick up babies and fly off with them and shit.
I look up to that guy in more ways than most, all right? He's an inspiration. It's lucky to have him as a mentor in just life in general. So you guys should all try and find somebody like Todd to really guide you down the right path. Just saying. It stayed running. It said fuel pump 2 fail.
It was the same thing when we like slosh or sideways.
But now the fuel level is just reading 0.
Okay.
I don't know what that means either. You thought I was going down. I got way more in me than that.
We pulled the entire water pump off the spare motor. That's what took Philip.
concerned about that. Like, I'd love maybe at fuel or something if we could come up with a game plan, maybe try and peek in there when we fuel it, just to make sure there's not something that's going to park us.
You're not going to see much because all the foam is a problem.
Can we slide it up at all or no?
Maybe, but normally you got to take, to get really it out, you got to, because you only got that big of a hole, you got to take that plate off.
Okay.
But I mean, 10 or 15 minutes, I guess I could have it out.
That's my only concern is, I mean, maybe if, I'll talk to him about it, but if we can take that 10 or 15 and then not.
Yeah.
Because if we're just, if it's only running one now on this and still not showing level, I just worry that there's something going on inside. Hopefully not, but Mike's is not the funnest place to hang out.
No.
You guys don't want to drive the route.
How much, Orin?
$2,500.
Okay, I'll give him $2,500 when I get back.
No, do you want me to buy?
It's all day. Course is rough as hell. Same, about 80% of the same course that we ran at the 500, so it's chewed up. Overall, it's going to be technical. It's going to be tight, and slow, choppy, but the weather's getting better, and my daughter's coming down Friday, so let's do it. And my wife. Love you too, honey.
Drain a little?
Man. You trying to sit on my side?
Are you back here on this side? Yeah, I'll go to the other side. Oh, because Bryce.
Yeah.
You need to buy, the long guy needs to be up behind the short guy. And the short guy needs to be behind the long guy.
Come on.
I apologize, you know? Seat etiquette, we don't really practice that in Florida, all right?
Hey, Bryce, are you planning on doing any pre-running with us in the morning before qualifying at all?
Probably not. I would say probably not.
Okay, so all we gotta do is make sure this is out, chase you around after qualifying.
Yep, for sure.
Okay, just trying to get the workload figured out in my head.
Yep, perfect. Thank you.
Always a good sign. You want to start out the race, qualifying a race day with a fresh smell and helmet.
Edgar.
Yeah. I sprayed some stuff in there.
Megan.
Oh, here he is. Number 71 in your program, number one in your heart, out of Litchfield Park, Arizona. Jammin' Jesse Jones! Woo! Woo!
Oh, man.
How is it? Prison?
Yeah.
I just went and watched qualifying. There's a lot of places for me to fuck up.
It looks slippery.
It looks real slippery and narrow.
Yeah. All right, I'll see you guys later.
Bye. Good luck today, buddy.
Like good luck to you guys.
Here we go. Got your first dang in her.
I have like five notes from the 2022 400 on that little section.
And then it just comes down like this shit right here and starts right there. Or maybe it starts over here. Because that's like the very first like gnarly ditch. It's right there.
Yeah, which you blew that corner.
Yep.
In 21.
No, yep.
Yeah.
Shaq.
do a special deal?
I like these, dude.
You like those? You're going old school, huh? You want a pair, son?
Are these me boys or what?
Yeah.
Pit wipers.
This truck works good.
You've worn that helmet before, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's like it's got scratches in it.
Yeah.
Still beat this guy.
It's racing.
That's racing.
Qualifying. I had a plan, top five. The course is very technical, tight, not many miles, 340 miles, so you want to be up front, but we had other plans. Qualifying, somehow a rock got in between the rear end and the fuel cell and ripped the brakes out on the very first G out, so we had about 5 miles left. So I shut off rear brakes, just had fronts, and did the best we could, but we're gonna be starting near the back, so we'll see how this one goes.
I overshot that big U-turn. I tried to cut it inside, but then it kind of pushed to the outside, and I went through the bushes. I'm like, whatever.
Good traction in those bushes.
Yeah. Brady's like, go, go. I'm like, fuck. What if there's a rock here? I don't know. Like, shit. This is the moment when it should happen if it was gonna go wrong. So let's not do anything stupid. But no, it was great. Hopefully I didn't give you guys my bad juju I've had here.
I would say we're normally used to, we have usually, you know, top three qualifying runs most of the time. We had an issue where a rock got jammed into our fuel cell that ended up taking our rear brake line off. As you can see in some of the in-car footage that we posted out there, you can see Bryce had to unbuckle his seatbelts, get in, close the valve to block off the rear brake line, and just run on front brakes. Considering all that, you know, finishing in the top 10, I think we ended up six, is really good for us, for the team, for him, knowing that, you know, he's definitely got the speed, and especially in this race, it'll be good.
So this Baja 400 is a really technical course. You know, we've been running a lot of stuff down here. The roads that used to be smooth are getting real, real chewed up. I mean, even from Ojos Negros to K77, those 40 miles, I mean, there's like 15 miles of like crazy 3.5 foot deep supercross whoops. I mean, every time you come around a corner, there's supercross whoops. So it's really changed, which I think it's really gonna affect the finishing rate for a lot of these teams. You know, I think it's going to be really tough to run a smooth, clean race. I think if you have if you push too hard, you're going to have an issue at this one. So I think it's going to be smooth and consistent and as fast as you can go without hurting equipment. But it's got to, you know, you start out, it's really technical, tight, rough. You know, you burn through Mike's Sky Ranch loop, which is a hard, slow, technical loop. You do the crossover road, which starts getting faster. Then you run the coast from Colonnette up to Santo Tomas, which is probably the funnest, fastest roads we do on the north side of Baja. And then straight into Uripan, which now is just, I dread Uripan. Those 40 miles across back to Ojos Negros, that's the roughest, nastiest stuff that we see. So, you know, it's the end of the race, you're tired, you're worn out, you're a little fatigued from 8 hours of running hard through rough stuff already. And you hit that and you just dread it. You know, you don't have the mental strength anymore. And it's just a matter of just going and trying to survive that as fast as possible to get back into town.
So this race, we're running two trucks, which is, you would think, two trucks, you know, twice the work. But no, it actually makes it like four times the work. It's quite a bit more logistics, you know, logistics-wise, trying to plan everybody. You got to keep everybody, you know, more stationary as the pits goes. You know, and that's in a perfect case scenario.
Off-road racing is, it's very challenging. These race trucks, you think they just go home from a race and hang out until the next race, but we take them home, we tear them completely down. And for this race especially, we had two trucks that we had to do. So the guys at the shop are huge. They worked thousands of hours getting these trucks ready, countless nights. And to be able to do that is very challenging. And you never see that behind the scenes. You don't see them, how much work they put in every single day, whether it's mounting 100 tires to come down to these races, whether it's getting all these chase trucks ready to make sure, you know, the oil's changed in them, the tires are looking good, down to all of our fuel safety stuff for all the pit guys. I mean, there's so much stuff that goes on that people don't see. They think we just jump in these trucks and go race, but there's massive amounts of stuff that happens. Every air bottle has to be checked. Every fuel regulator has to be checked. It's just endless amounts of work that go into a month of getting stuff ready. And for this race, it's two. We have two trucks running. So now we have two different plans. If anything goes wrong, you have to have a plan for that. It just makes it so much more. But I have the team that's willing to do it. They're dedicated. They never complain. They love going to work. They love working on these trucks. And I think you have to have that in order to win these races and also win a championship, which is extremely hard nowadays.